Yeah, hello again for and welcome to this video, right? For another session here of playing some games on Leecher. So, what do we go for? 3 plus 2? I guess so, right? Let's go 3 plus 2 and go. Huh. I did really wreck my rating, right? I got some points back from yesterday's sessions due to cheating, but still not great. Didn't really have a good session there. Okay, 5c3. Against this, I'm also recommending e5, and white seems to know the theory here. Okay, so I'm just going to play what I have in the Magnus course. Pretty surprised that he's dashing out everything immediately. Oh, wow, that is a really, really tough line. The best move now is Queen B3, but this is super sharp. Knight A5, Bishop F7, King E7, Queen D5, Knight F6. Let's see what happens. If he doesn't play Queen B3, I'm not really in any danger. So here we go. I have a little bit of a head start here. I mean, I analyzed this, which doesn't mean I have to remember everything. This is sometimes tricky. I am the author of this course, but it doesn't mean that I can remember everything immediately in a blitz game. Okay, here there's nothing much to think about. He has to take f7. But the problem here is that white has to recognize that bishop f7, king e7, queen d5 actually happens. And now knight f6. Here you have to play bishop to g5. And now I have to think about this for a moment. Is it knight c6? Oh, Jesus Christ. Sorry. Is it knight c6? I think it is. I don't really remember. There's now, I think there's rook e1. Yeah. Rook e1, rook e1, rook f8. And I think e5 doesn't quite work, but I don't remember why. His bishop is trapped. So I take it. He can take now with the knight. Let me remember. Why on earth didn't that work? So queen takes d5. Bishop takes d5, knight e5, rook e5, king d6 for a double attack. Yeah, this is why it doesn't work. But whew, yeah, you really have to think, you really have to remember this. It's actually not completely over in blitz chess because, I mean, I'm winning material, but my king is out in the open. That's the beauty, if you really know your openings, you can sometimes just dash it out, and yeah, that's it. That was basically a win out of the opening. It is better for white to play, rook e1 is not correct. White can pull the plug here with e, not pull the plug, that's too much, but you can play e5 in this position. Okay, I have to go to analysis board. Better here is e5, I think, which should still be okay, if I remember correctly. That is something like, oh, what is best here? I don't quite remember. What is best here? e5? Rook e1, rook f8 is good, yeah? This is good for me. I thought e5 was right. D takes. Okay, I don't really want to make a memory contest out of this. go back to the starting position. I got the important stuff right. So let's create a new game. And also, I actually have tea. I just had to still sit for some minutes. Zribislav. Go D4. I wanted to mention something which is actually important. I just got two messages. One message is that many and all of my courses are actually on sale on Chessable because of Black Friday coming up. This is next week, I think, Black Friday. Not so much into the loop there because I don't know. I don't really care about this all that much. Don't need much new stuff. In any case, all of my courses are on sale, I think at least for a week. So if you wanted to get something there, including the Magnus course, the Fight Like Magnus course has been, the sale has been prolonged due to Black Friday, it seems. So yeah, if you want to get any of those, now it's a good time. You can save a bit of money if you get that. And then the second message is that the print book, Keep It Simple 1D4, is printed actually and should be available from Monday. So we're talking about like online stores. Again, I only got the message that this should be the case, so don't blame me if it doesn't work out for sure. I don't know about Amazon, for example. I just got a call by a friend of mine who has a chess mail order service, and he said the books will be there on Monday or Tuesday, something like that, early next week. So it's also on UN Chess website. So if you want to get Keep It Simple D4 as a print book, it is available very shortly. If you already have this on Chessable and wonder, does the print book differ? The answer is no. This is basically one-to-one. I think I probably changed one single line or something like that, but that's it. And this is a very, very minor thing. Now, okay, in this game, let's think about this. I have a pretty nice position, of course. The thing is, he's got Queen c6. Queen c6 looks like a real annoyance. Knight g5 is looking good, but he's got Queen c6. Okay, but I can actually take on e6 with check, so I don't mind Queen c6. Let's take it. Yeah, King h8, Knight f7 wins. Knight f7, King g8, Knight d8, check. Wins the house. And Rook takes, Queen takes, I can pre-move actually. That's just an exchange. Or nothing much. This should lead to basically the same thing. No, I shouldn't pre-move. I know he might play queen takes or something odd. Now queen takes is a check. So I'll take this and I'm an exchange up. I don't think he's got any compensation there. No. Nothing inside. Let's say bishop d6, get this traded. Hey, he might have bishop f3, and then I take e7. Let's do this. This is a simple way to do it. Trade one bishop. Okay. I take now, rook d8, check, king f7. There is no immediate win. Not sure what he's considering. Rook e7 should be forced, right? I also got some messages about analysis view that the computer line is not visible. Yeah, I saw that. I never think this is really relevant because I'm going to tell you the computer lines. So it doesn't really help if you see, I don't know, one random move with an evaluation there. I mean, random move, sorry, it's not a random move, but if you just see the isolated move with some line, I don't really think it helps much. I have to check it. This complicates the OBS setup a little bit. But I will look at this. Okay. Yeah, knight d5 or this one, don't know. This looks like reasonably simple way to win as well. So yeah, I don't mind if he takes a2. I should be by far too quick here in the with my rooks. Like rook d8 coming, knight d7 or things like that should be far too much. Yeah, knight d7. This is much simpler. Now against the knight has no, has absolutely no support there from a pawn. Just check what's better, rook e7 or rook e6 or rook e5. They all look pretty strong, but rook e7 must be very strong. Now let's go here. And the knight has no way to go to a square that a pawn supports it, and that's just a real big issue. Rook d8 is the immediate threat and he resigns. I think not much to check here. I think this looks pretty straightforward. So let's go for new opponent. BP55. Okay, I can try the Rogozin again. I don't even know if this is on sale. Probably it is also on sale, the Rogozin course. Yeah, I got that recently and forgot the theory. I mean, it should be perfectly okay. Even though I don't think this is what I recommended in the course. Now, you know, earlier I could recall the Magnus line. That is still pretty fresh in my memory. But stuff that I looked at like 3 months ago, so more difficult. And I'm not really repeating the lines on Chessable as I should, but you know, I always have something new to write. So I'm always focused on the latest thing, let's say, that I wrote. Now, this is a little bit awkward with the queen on f5. I don't know if he actually threatens something. I doubt it. Yeah, maybe knight c5 in some cases. It's a bit awkward, it really is. Knight b4. Doesn't feel right. Now he's got c7 is always hanging in this position. That makes it a bit awkward. I don't know if this is good. Okay, just goes back. I didn't expect that. Thought you would take, actually. Okay, knight f6 is not yet a threat, but close. Yeah, white is better. I did not play this. Well. And he's ahead on the clock by a mile. Really, by a mile. Wow. Okay. I'm playing this badly, but it seems that this is all coming very easy to him. Yeah, I cannot play this due to rook c7. This is probably just over. Yeah. I don't see a mate, but well, I manage like knight f6, then I'm consolidating this a little bit. I think he should have taken a bit more time there and tried to figure out a clean win. Maybe this is a clean win, I'm not saying it isn't, but I currently don't see why it's a clean win. Okay, so knight f6 would push the queen back. Let's do this. Now he's probably trying to play like e4 or something. I got no time at all. Yeah. Now he can just go e5. Okay. Couldn't move it. Okay. Whatever you want, it's just completely lost. Bishop check, knight f, knight h7 wins very clearly. It doesn't see it. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Now here I just got annihilated. That was not good at all. I was a bit stunned how quickly you played that. I mean, but okay, good job. I think I have to play it differently here, but I don't quite remember. I mean, you can always just play something simple like take on c3. But I thought that this was interesting, but it didn't work out at all. So here Qc2 is very strong, not trading of course. And then he found all the good stuff, h4. Yeah, knight to g5. Of course, it did not really register to me that he was immediately threatening to sacrifice. If I would have seen that, I would have found queen e8 and continued the game. It's uncomfortable, but those positions can still be quite tough. Yeah, here after knight f7, I'm just annihilated. He missed a couple of simpler wins, but there wasn't really much that I could do. Here knight f6 was saving me, actually. Huh, that's actually true. Rook takes. Yeah, and this is a position that you can play. So, yeah, he gave me some chance, but it was very, very slim. And here you just completely toast. Yeah, just a good job by white. Can you do? And the whole concept there was probably just faulty. So let's go for Nimzo. Yeah, here got a couple of good lines. We have queen c2 is odd. White is losing quite a bit of time with this approach. So, yeah, I can go d5 immediately, but there's also something like this, like b6. Now, if I take and go d5, I want to open the position, so going to do that. It takes, I'm taking with the queen. This looks completely fine. This is surprising. I think that I should be in pretty good shape here, because I would have rook c8 next, and this looks awkward. Doesn't care at all. Or knight a5. Maybe this is stronger. Could be stronger. I'm very quickly mobilized here. Rook c8 is the threat. And yeah, so rook c8. Now, and where's the queen going? Not many great squares. Now, bishop d5 is a good strategic move. Just wonder, yeah, I don't see anything clearly better. So let's go with this one, trying to trade the bishops, and it should be working. So now, bishop d2. Seems he wants to take on a5, which is... Yeah, it's not a problem per se. But if he takes it on a, if he takes a5 now, right? That's the only reasonable move. What do I do? I can just take. I can just capture. Yeah, this is also better for black. I can just take on a5. Okay, this felt worse, because now I just have I don't even have to worry about like a double pawn. Now knight b3 looks good. Just attack the rook. Knight on b3 looks like a strong piece. So is he going? Yeah, so let's just centralize everything. Oops, sorry. Yeah, the knight should come to d5 maybe. He's got knight e5 possibly coming. Okay, I can actually anchor the knight with a4. Now my queen can move. That can prove to be useful. I mean, the knight was not attacked, but it was always a liability. And I think it is still strong there, covering c1 to prevent. Rook c1 should be useful. Okay, now I can even just take it. This is also very favorable. Come on, let's do the simple thing. This is just a pretty awful bishop on c3. And I have these rook c4, rook c2 things, all and due to the very strong knight on b3. Yeah, that looks very good. h6 was just a generally useful move to not get back rank mated. This is not a clear concern at the moment, but it could be. Yeah, white has problems here to actually move. It's all a little bit disorganized, let's say. This is a word. Cannot take now, probably rook c4, get that tempo in. Okay, now, if I take it, doesn't really net much. Not entirely certain how I'm getting to something concrete here. Oh. I didn't expect that. Not sure if it's good, I didn't expect it. Knight looks a bit off there. And I don't see how he attacks g4. Okay, so he's out for knight check here. That's indeed a bit annoying. Okay. Yeah, he's got some counterplay there against my king. Knight e7. Yes, great stuff. Losing this game is really a shame. I mean, it was such a one-sided game. Very stupid. Oh, it's made. Yeah, this is just terrible. I mean, white was, of course, I mean, sorry, but white was totally outplayed here. And And here, this is just absolutely dreadful. The thing that I probably should avoid is this g5 business. Just win the game on the queen side alone. Yeah, b4 seems to win here. Something simple. Yeah, g5 ultimately didn't help, I guess. It probably still wins, but it is just it's just complicated. Okay, here I can take and win very easily. Rook c2. Yeah, that was very badly played. I mean, losing the game is a real disgrace because White made so many strategic errors that, like, getting into this is already bad, pretty awful, and then allowing the bishop trade is just downright bad. You have to take on a5 here also. A knight d5. Okay. Why is that strong? I don't get it. Knight d5. Ah, the queen has absolutely no square here, and then I have bishop b3. Okay. Okay. There was a tactical justification. Okay, so another 3 plus 2. Not doing well here at all. I mean, you should just win games like that if they make enough strategic mistakes for 3 games. You should win it. But yeah, the conversion is always something that requires a concrete lines, and if you play it so stupid. So let's see. Oh, taking quite a bit of time here early on. Yeah, this is, I think, a pretty good line for White. Also featured in my d4 book. Okay, now, how do we do this? So, bishop a4 looks completely normal, but... yeah. Maybe we just go back to e2, so that c4 is actually a possibility. So, bishop takes d6 is a strategic threat, I guess. It's a bit difficult to, maybe he has to do something about it. Queen b6 or, like, if I get to take on d6, the issue is that his pieces on the queen side might be completely locked out. This is something that I already... Really? Well, where do you go from there? That I already had in a game, in a Banter Blitz once. I'm pretty stunned. So, if I'm attacking the knight, like queen d3, what is he doing then? f5? Yeah, I guess so. It's the kind of thing, if you don't win, you feel terrible, because this cannot be good. F5. Oh, he just drops back, okay. That looks healthier than F5. Still, the overall assessment cannot be in Black's favor here. At the end of the day, I'm on the e-file. Going to be difficult for him to ever move the e-pawn. So what to do with the e2 bishop? Maybe I can activate it here. Bishop to c2 was my idea. Maybe to a4 in some cases. It seems that he wants to just move the bishop. I'm ready for b3. My queenside is perfectly safe. Yeah, with b3 I've got a perfect pawn chain. Then I can try to pile up on the e-file. Yeah, she's out for knight e5. That makes quite a bit of sense. So I'm going to play b3. Yeah, I'm not so happy here. It looked really odd what Black was doing, and I couldn't quite refute it. Queen a5, I play bishop d2. Ultimately f4 needs to happen. Okay. Just a small improvement move. A5, I'm just going to go A4, block the whole thing. Probably. Yeah, so let's get F4 in. Now F4 is a threat. Bishop D7 just deprived the knight of its only retreat square. Yeah. Bishop has to move. Wow. Okay. Yet another severe weakness. Bishop h6. Yeah, that's probably the right move. Wait, if I take e5, I'm really slow tactically here. I can just take this, of course. Yeah, that's mate on g7. Couldn't quite believe that he can get away with all that. And he couldn't. Still, I wonder if I did this right. Probably not perfectly played. I mean, very sure not perfectly played. But probably the improvement wasn't something extraordinarily difficult. So, okay. Really? Knight e5. So let's go. I'm surprised actually that this line with c takes, that this is actually still so frequently played, because it's just pretty much toothless. I mean, it's not like terrible for white, but absolutely not dangerous for black. Yeah, this is one of those famous last words. Yeah, I'm just saying, harmless, and then plundering the house probably. But I really think this is not very dangerous. I have a very reasonable development, and it's not quite clear. So it seems that he wants to go. I don't know what he wants to do. Just going to develop everything. Aha, okay. So knight g3 maybe next. Okay, not certain where to go. I think c7 looks okay. I have queen b6 possibly. I want to go rook d8 and queen to b6, so feels like a reasonable setup. I already have some pressure on the pawn. It's, he has to think about this a little bit, how to set up his pieces, and white is far away from any sort of attacking scheme with the bishop on h5 instead of c8 or e8 as it is sometimes is in those structures. White has no attacking ideas really. A simple idea here could be knight f6, simply attacking the knight and opening up the d-file for rook and knight to ultimately win that pawn. This I cannot quite believe, really. So I can take on f3. So let's say I take this first, right? And now he will take with the bishop, I guess. Now I take on g5. And now how do we win the pawn? It should be very close, really, that the pawn is dropping. Knight e7, maybe. Still having knight f5 in some cases. See, queen c2 or something. Not easy for white to defend this. Yeah, here queen f4, I thought, would be good. Gaining this tempo on the knight, which is unprotected, so knight e4, I guess, and then I take d4 for not much, to put it mildly. No, that's really, really bad. But I don't see what else. The knight is attacked and there is no good way to cover it, I think. Yeah, this is probably I can take. I wonder, do we have something more here actually? What about knight f5 in this position? Knight f5? Knight f5, rook d3. Yeah, that looks okay, right? Yeah. This is one of those cases where the isolated pawn was just not giving enough activity. Okay, now, is there a tactical win? If I take here? I'm just a little bit cautious because of the back rank. So this looks good, right? He cannot take with the rook as the queen is hanging. Queen takes, I take on c1. And pawn takes, pawn takes, I can take d3, right? There's no back rank stuff. Okay. So he left. I would have offered a rematch. I cannot click rematch. I can't click rematch. But he's not on anymore. Okay, I wouldn't have minded one. Ah, okay. Here it is. So let's go here. Should probably use the word so less. Somehow this is a routine of mine. Or routine is wrong. Bad habit is probably the right way to call it. Yeah. Let's see if he knows the best defense here, which is bishop d7. However, quite large group of players take on e5 early on. This is good for white. Now c takes d4 is the best move. This has some drawback. I think it has some drawback. You can play this very, very technically, let's say, by taking on c6 and just claim that this is a better pawn structure with some justification. Knight ac4, cd4 is just a transposition to a main line, and this is probably not the best. Don't quite remember. Maybe bishop e7 is not so bad. It's possible. It might be that this is just too technical. I'm going to be a little bit better, I think, due to the pawn structure, but it's nothing extraordinarily threatening for black. One key pointer is very likely that c3 is happening. Okay, didn't do that. Okay, queen c2 then. Now c3 I can take with the queen. So I should get this position that I mentioned with the slightly better pawn structure due to the c6 pawn. This is not really all that much, but it is definitely a small advantage and a very one-sided advantage. This is something that is often underappreciated. It's sometimes not just about that you're somewhat better, it's also a case where the opponent's counterplay is very limited. Just as I say that, I allowed queen h5, which was absolutely not necessary to allow. So h4, and now he's got g5. I don't know if this is a good move. It's a bit weakening as well. Okay. Okay, is rook b5 on, or what is the deal? I'm a little bit scared. Definitely would like to trade this knight. Maybe I go here, knight d2, intending knight f3, just to save everything. I shouldn't have allowed queen h5 with this, basically forcing me to play h4. This is a really awkward move to play. I probably cannot do without b3 in the long run. So let's go there just to be safe. So if I'm not mated, I can always claim a small advantage, because the strategic damage here is difficult to fix. Now, okay, I'm taking it, I guess, or queen e4 is also not terrible, I guess. Let's go queen e4. Maybe that was bad. Giving him d5 forever. And here he is on d5. Yeah, I still feel that I can press a little bit here. g5 is not dangerous anymore. My king is safe after king g2. I will go king g2 probably. So that f3 is covered and I can actually move the queen. The general problem for black is that his disadvantage here is completely static. And it's very hard to see how he can completely overcome this problem, as you not easily get rid of the c pawn. Here, black's queen is actually... Oh, he allows me to take. That is something that I cannot resist, actually. Now, how to do that? Rook d8. Rook d8. This is stopping the d pawn. And pairing rook 1 to c8. So 1 to c8. Not certain about e5, as the queen then is severely limited. Okay, g4 and h5. That's going to be tough. Oh no, wait. If I check first, king g6. Don't see. Let's do this. This is good enough. Cannot take with the queen. And this I cannot believe in the long run. Maybe not even in the short run. I don't see a mate there. God damn it. Ah! He's just coming up with the king, eh? Heavens. I can take g4. Unbelievable stuff here, really. Got 10 seconds. I shouldn't forget that. I don't have to completely panic here. Rook f5. I don't know if that is enough. Let's go here. I did panic somewhat, actually. I can go there. I'm just an idiot. King c4. Why don't I play king c4? This is so terrible. It's just completely easy. Just go king c4. I'm not even threatening to move the pawn then. This is very frustrating. I mean, no. I really don't want to play again. I mean, this is just like completely over here, this position. This is just unbelievable that this is not winning. Why isn't that winning? I mean, it is not actually. The engine, okay, like probably if you give it enough time, but it's not like an obvious win, which is completely crazy. I mean, rook c5 seems to be best, but g4 also wins. I just have to be more precise. Rook e8 is winning here. H5 is not enough. Not enough. This would also win, I guess. Or what the engine tells me. Rook h8, why is that winning? Yeah, this is actually right. Yeah, he cannot move forward. And once he was there, it's fine. He just escaped there. Just escaped. And now he don't have time to figure it out. Yeah, h4 would win now, and somewhere here we're probably, it should be a draw, but then I made that completely terrible move. Yeah, black wins with a6. But now just king c4. I don't know what I was thinking. I mean, I didn't think anything, probably. This is just, of course, a draw. I don't know. b5 is just brain dead. Anyway, okay, so let's go back and play another one. That is really bad. I mean, that he actually allowed me to get to two rooks against queen is really crazy. The position should be immediately over, and it wasn't for some reason. At least I needed to be precise, which I wasn't. And it made absolutely no sense to allow it. I mean, black could just play whatever. Yeah, I'm just giving up far too many points. Okay. I would actually claim that it doesn't even work. Played it immediately. Okay. So I'm taking here. So I'm winning some material now. After the knight, move e5. Attacks the rook, attacks the bishop. Okay, now taking this. Yeah, I kind of have to. Otherwise knight d5 will happen. Yeah, d4 is attacked, so I got to take. Rook a7, I assume, is good. It's still not easy. I mean, he just blundered the exchange. That wasn't an intended sacrifice. The whole line looks pretty awful. But it's still not an automatic win, simply because like d4 is a bit weak. He will gain a bit of time, and so on. My piece configuration is, of course, not ideal. And the bishop will be strong on the long diagonal. Yeah. Don't want to play knight f3, this is just too passive. Now, yeah, one thing that I thought about, if I should just take on e7 and then knight d6 check, so that he has to move the king. Let me do that. I just don't want to defend this position. I want to be on the defensive, is what I'm trying to say. This is a much more active way to play. Yeah, it's probably also just stronger. Why that? Isn't this a free move? Okay. I'm losing this one as well. I might as well switch to bingo. Yeah, c6 is attacked, so I can just take this. But bishop takes f6 also looks pretty strong. Yeah, I'm just taking the material, come on. Yeah, that's mate here, only 8. Alright, so that was pretty awful. One more game, maybe. Okay, so a Sicilian, at least. Maybe I can win out of the opening, that's a way to do it. Making too many odd decisions later. I don't think knight c3 is very challenging. The whole configuration here doesn't really look that suited for queenside play with the knight on c3. But okay, got more than one option. I think I'm going for this stop this for the moment. Before, I mean. Yeah, maybe rook b1 here or queen b1, ideas like that. Yeah, it's a tough call. I can play many things here. One advantage of the knight on c3 is that, like, if it's on d2, you sometimes can play a quick f5, f4, trying to use that bishop position. This is not happening here. I would expect him to play something to prepare b4 even more. Another reasonable move could be knight d2 to prepare f4. That doesn't scare me really, but something like prep move for b4 would be. Would be more of a concern. Yes, so this prepares b4. How do we play this? So I go here. Now, if I take it, my idea was to take twice and play b5. I hope that this works. I don't think there is much going on if I just get to castle, let's say, just to coordinate, then this doesn't feel dangerous. It takes a bit of time till c4 becomes a serious idea. To attack my pawn. Yeah, I just thought knight d7 would be good. Why isn't that good? The knight is completely fine on d7 anyway. Oh, interesting. Oh, but is it good? So I take it. And now, I mean, bishop f8 is the slowest move in the world. But if I just get c5, I cannot resist it, actually. If I castle, he has queen d6. Which isn't bad either, but if I can just take c5, it's just game over. Yeah, I don't see what he's doing there against this. He has to do something really drastic. Okay, I know. Peace sacrifice. Knight d5. Well, that doesn't work. Yeah, it's a bit strange because I got nothing developed, but it still works. This is the relatively best chance, maybe. At least I don't have to think about this, I just have to take. Now bishop b7, covering the rook. Okay, yes. Queen b5. I should probably cover this, yeah? Just cover it. Yes. Got a piece now. I don't need to do anything fancy. I just have to castle. It's a very simple concept. Get the king out of danger. Oh, I didn't have to check. Okay. Now I can take d6. What is actually best? Yeah, I can take d6. Anything quicker? No. Back rank mate is the thing. Cannot take on c6. Yeah, it was a bit odd, but I think it was fine. I don't know. So if we check this after b4, I took b4, takes, takes, rook takes, b5. Yeah, the engine evaluates this as equal, which seems fair if white doesn't go. This bishop c5 and then d4 just doesn't work, I think. And after something normal, I castle and just it's a game. White has a bit of a better pawn structure, but I got the two bishops long term. This is just doesn't do it. Yeah, the engine says like minus 2.3 here. Which I just win the pawn. Knight d5 is a desperate one, but okay, you don't have anything. Yeah, bishop c5 next will end the game. So one more game. Come on, like one more game. Really? Let's switch the light on. Like sitting here in the dark. Oh, Doc he won. Is that John Nunn? I don't know. Doki always was John Nunn back in the ICC days, and he plays the King's Indian. Doesn't have a GM attached. In any case, a highly rated player. So let's see what he's coming up with. Yeah, this is more or less a theoretical position. A theoretical position that I would consider to be very marginally more comfortable for white due to the b5 weakness. Slightly annoying for black to play this, but with precision, black should be okay. Yeah, I wonder what's best. I'm not sure that I'm threatening all that much. Queen takes b7 could be a bit dicey, really. Yeah, okay, so rook c1, I need to go there anyway. Ah, okay, that was the idea. Let's say we trade. Yeah, trading is definitely not the most ambitious thing to do, but there's not much else actually. With the bishop on e4, it's a bit difficult to untangle. I don't want to trade those, but whenever I move the knight, I have to. I'm unsure. Is this an idea? Interesting. Bishop takes bishop d7. It's probably still completely equal. Yeah, it is completely equal. If he moves the knight, I can move my knight away. Yeah, so go here. I'm currently at least preventing a4. And he has to somehow lend protection to the pawn here with the rook. And b6, we can c6 a little bit. So it's very, very, very little. Bishop d2. Okay, that's a dynamic solution, of course. Yeah, that's not bad. Not bad. I don't see anything good here, to be honest. So I'm going for this thing, which is of course nothing, just completely equal, I guess. Yeah, that looks very equal. He's got a little bit, he's a bit more active. A little bit more active here. Okay, I don't have to take actually, but I probably will. So, yeah, I'm going to offer a draw here. I don't know if he wants to continue this. It's a bit of a boring game, but I just didn't get anywhere. So, but it's such a solid position that you can that is difficult to lose. Let's say. Okay, I went with the rematch. So good to have a strong opponent. What? Is that a ingenious sacrifice or just a blunder? Probably just a blunder. I'm not sure if I want to take the exchange though. I think I'm fine with just having a pawn. He won a bit of time there, but the closed nature of the position, I think, should mean that I'm okay. Huh, I just wonder, do I really want to play e5 anymore? You usually always play e5, but I'm not sure here because I already won a pawn and it could be a difficult thing here in this position. A different thing, that's what I'm trying to say. Okay. For example, here, I mean, it makes sense that I'm having this diagonal open. Often, if you have not won b2, this is not really relevant because white is, there's just not much happening on that diagonal. But here, this could be different. Okay, so b5. Get to attack a5. It's not so easy to cover. Rook a1. It's not a really good move. c4. Let's activate this. Okay, yeah, it's not so good to take this at the moment, a5. But I think I can cover c4. And to go from here, rook d8. Now e5 should be a threat. Actually, after e5, what would he have done after that? Knight e2, probably. Okay, let's not focus on this too much. What was going on before? Just have to focus on the position here. Attack e4. Yeah. Oh, it's a bit annoying, actually. Taking e4 is not really good. I didn't want to give him this bishop. Okay, so g takes f5, bishop c5. There's something good there. Nothing that I'm aware of. Okay. Yeah, this didn't go so well. Knight f5 was a strong move. Okay, knight g5. I want to play with knight d4 here if possible. It weakens d5 though, so rook d1, rook d5, ideas like that could now be tricky. Now knight d4. Yeah, I think it's useful to do this. At least that prevents rook to d1 due to knight e2, I guess. And I would like to play something like e5 and f6, to. Oh, okay. That I did not think about at all. I got rook b1. I don't know if it does much. Knight e2 is also close to working, but at least that looks interesting. He cannot take due to knight e2. I'm threatening knight e2, and there is some other stuff going on. The knight is also kind of hanging. Not quite sure what his reply is. He has to find a move in the first place that he can play. Currently not seeing what it is. So he goes into this thing, into this pin here. I cannot believe there isn't a win. Maybe this one? Queen H1 mate? So I won a piece. Okay. Whew. Wow. Oh, that was interesting. Whew. That was a tough one. I mean, he just blundered the b2 pawn. But yeah, it still was somewhat interesting. So take. And I don't really feel confident in grabbing the exchange there. It might just be right, but in particular in a blitz game, this looks pretty dangerous. I have no development like this. Yeah. It should not be enough objectively, but I was scared. So I just went b6 and just played this position. And black should be better simply due to the pawn, but it's not easy to always find the right continuation. So b5, knight b3, c4. Computer is kind of okay with my play, giving me some advantage. And now it wants to go e5 and push the knight back to e2. That makes an awful lot of sense. I just didn't really realize that e5 was still in this position. A6, not bad. Yeah, the computer kind of approves of what I'm doing, but knight c5 is wrong. I have to find something better here, like c5 maybe, or rook b8. All of those moves give black a pretty good advantage. I just didn't see knight f5, of course. I just didn't see the move. And now things are okay for white again. I don't necessarily think he's much better. King takes, check. Yeah. Engine likes my play. I think Engine says that I'm slightly better here. And now it's probably getting a little bit more. Rook b8. Yeah, knight c4, rook b1 wins. Yeah, there's no defense. I didn't see a move. I didn't see a move either in this position. So king h1 and queen h2 is winning. Why is bishop c4 also winning? I don't see that. I again the same idea, queen h2. So the computer is also saying that this is winning as well. Yeah, nice one with the mate. I found the same idea. The simplest one is actually rook b4, which simply picks up the knight. That would have been a good solution as well. Queen h2 is killing. F3, rook b4 is stronger, but okay, if you can get an ending with the piece up, you should take it. So I think that was a good end of a pretty sketchy session, yeah, some pretty bad play. And now it's really dark. Thanks a lot for watching. I'll be back tomorrow, I guess. Bye-bye.